What's your, do you have three quads that you're the most proud of?
Fran. Fran and Fran, I don't know. I hate that thing.
Greg, can you tell them where Fran came from?
I, as a young gymnast in just new to high school, I entertained the notion I could become a stronger gymnast with weights, and the conclusion of that experiment was a fuck yeah, you know, and surprisingly, it was really hard to communicate to other gymnasts that you should be lifting weights. And there were things you could develop on the rings with weights, strength-wise, that were pretty hard to do just on the rings. Part of the reason was that just getting above the rings took a lot of energy and it made a lot of stuff hard for reps, where it wasn't the case with weights. But anyways, old man was cool enough to back the station wagon out of the garage and clean it up for me and let me convert it into a weight training facility. And this was in 1972, and it took me down to Sears, and for $19.95, 110-pound weight set, and it was a Ted Williams, the baseball player, had to put his name on a weight set, and it was a blue plastic cement filled, and pulled the station wagon out of the garage, and I was a competitive gymnast, and I needed something that would make you sit on your ass and gasp for air, simulating 2-minute ring routine, P-bar routine, and that's what they would do early in the season, right? They were brutal in terms of the cardiorespiratory demands, and simultaneously, I mean, no one doubts it. Gymnasts have to be strong. And if you get off the apparatus and you're hunched over, or you vomit, or you're gate-mouth breathing hard, wild and terror, you will be deducted for that. And so you have to get off and look cool as a cucumber, like, that was fun. or it's held against you, and so the conditioning was a critical component. Well, I'm looking through this Ted Williams guide to weightlifting, and the morons doing lateral raises and curls, and I'm like, that's got none of the feeling. There's no amount of lateral raises or curls that's going to sum to what I feel when I do this. And so I just stumbled across, well, if you bring the bar to the chest and get as low as you can and drive it to overhead, the thruster is born. That's, you know, 10 of those takes me towards that feeling. And so I had a pull-up bar in the door jam in the garage out to the outside, and it was one of those Voigt, it was an AMF product, the thing that you twist and expand into the jam. Remember those? Remember those, Skip? Yep. You know, the best mount of a doorway pull-up bar ever was when you took the rubber caps off of that and open it up until it digs into the jam an inch each way. That's the one that won't come out. And parents love that. So I don't know where it came from, but I did 21 of these thrusters and 21 pull-ups and 15 of each, 9 of each, and unceremoniously threw up all over the garage floor. My German Shepherds cleaned it up. And isn't that disgusting? And I went over to cross the street and knocked on my buddy's door. Brian is a fellow gymnast, and he answers the door. He's, dude, what's all over your shirt? I'm like, never mind that, come with me. And a trainer is born, right? And we did the same thing, and he did the same thing. And we cleaned up, and I like, let's go get your brother. And we went and go into the house and go to his brother's room, and he's like, what's on you guys? You smell like vomit, you know? And we're like, come on. He's like, I don't think so. You know? And much of what we see everywhere today, I saw that day, you know, that's about the numbers and how it plays out, and a workout was born. It's just that simple. Just try something. And you know, what did I like about it? It wasn't the vomit. What I knew is that felt like what the rings feel like. Just like my cops will tell you, that's what a long foot chase and fight feels like. Like my martial artists will tell you, that's what that's what, you know, it was BJ Penn that offered up on in terms of fight gone bad. That we did the workout for him and then asked him, how'd that feel? And he says, it felt like a fight gone bad. And, you know, wow, that's enough to hold on to something. And I hate that thing. We were going to take a athlete and put a heart rate monitor on, a downloadable heart rate monitor, and on one of our studettes, and then tell them at a seminar, you're going to do Fran in 5 minutes and mark the time and just watch what happens to the heart rate. Because few things will fill you with as much dread as knowing that some of these things are coming. And I know that both Josh Everett and Greg Amundsen have vomited in anticipation of something coming, just through nervous anxiety. You know?
What about the name? Where'd Fran come from?
You'd say, okay, you're going to do 21 thrusters. What's that? Okay, well, actually, it's 21 front squat with a follow-through press, and then in a contiguous set, and then the following set, you're going to do 21 pull-ups, and you have to complete all 21 because you go to the next exercise, break it up anyway, blah, 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 blah. It takes 5 minutes to explain the fucker. I want to explain it once and give it a name. And I thought that anything that left you flat on your back looking up at the sky, asking what the fuck happened to me, deserved a female's name. Right? Yeah, what happened to me? And they're not old girlfriends, and it's just like storms, you know? If a hurricane that wreaks havoc and the whole town can be Fran, so could a workout.